Hi, welcome to Green Living. I'm Paolo Abrera. Take a look around your houses and office spaces. Aside from papers, what is it you usually see? If you see a lot of these, then it only attests to the fact that plastic bottles can be found anywhere on the earth. Plastic bottles are known for their usefulness and cheap cost. Almost every beverage, food, and other commercial products can be found packaged in these containers. However, despite the usefulness of plastic bottles, they are also the source of a really big problem. Plastic bottles account for a large part of the waste generated by society. It takes 700 years for a bottle like this to decompose. Yet about 80% of the world's plastic bottles are not recycled. Recycling these plastic bottles not only has benefits for the environment, but also to your daily lives as well. That's why today I'm going to show you two DIY projects to save your bottles from being dumped. All that later, but first, save your day and indulge with a freshly brewed cup of craft coffee. The drinking and enjoyment of coffee is widespread all over the world. People rely on this famous drink as a wake-me-upper, as a break during a busy day, or a drink to enjoy with a company of friends. Whether you take each cup seriously or you simply love the aroma and taste of coffee, you better drop by Craft Coffee Workshop. Here, you get and learn about the perfect cup of joe.
Oh, welcome to Craft. Come in.
Hey, I'm Peter Ong. I'm the Managing Director for Craft Coffee Workshop. Basically, Craft Coffee Workshop sells roasted coffee beans, and then we also do workshop, we conduct classes, and then lastly, we have a cafe wherein we serve our coffees. Craft Coffee Workshop started as a dream by two persons. Sly and Raymond. So Raymond is an espresso machine supplier, and then Sly is a coffee geek, or he likes to collect stuff, like coffee stuff. So he bought a machine from Raymond, and from there they started a friendship. Both of them dream of having a roastery cafe, so they decided to open one, so they tagged me along to join the group. For Sly and Raymond, they started young, so they like coffee. Nung bata pa sila, ako late and bloomer ako for coffee because I kind of started wrong. I tasted bad coffee before, so I thought coffee is really bad. So I stopped drinking coffee for a while. So nung nakilala ko lang sila, and then I got a chance to taste their coffee, then, masarap pa lang coffee. So doon lang lumabas yung passion ko for coffee.
The passion for coffee is obvious at Craft Coffee Workshop. Here, they share and educate people about coffee. They hone their skills and train entrepreneurs and baristas to perfectly and carefully produce a cup of coffee.
We have two types of classes. We have the home barista classes and then the professional classes. So sa home barista classes, we teach mga starter how to brew their coffee using a small machine and then using mga slow brew methods like AeroPress, S-Pro, French Press, V60, or Siphon. Then sa professional naman, we train them how to use a bigger machine, how to pull shots, how to do mga menus ng coffees to start a cafe.
So today I'm tasting coffee from Kona. So basically to taste coffee, first we smell the aroma. And after it, slurp, or we incorporate air sa pag sip ng coffee. Like this. That. Then circulate sa buong mouth, sa buong palate natin. Yung taste notes na ito, Kona Coffee is, I taste fruited sweetness, and I also taste mellow acidity or medyo citrus acidity siya. Then the aftertaste is cocoa.
We need details, emphasis on the quality. Sa mga things na ano, sinaserve namin, we want a perfect cup of coffee. So from sourcing our beans, from roasting, until we pull the shot. So gusto namin lahat, parang perfect lahat.
This place is buzzing with activity. The day-to-day operations of the shop include coffee roasting, brewing, and serving excellent coffee.
Okay, here we have Elizabeth, our roaster. So here we roast our green beans. We use as a roast lager so that we'll have a perfect roast for each origin. Yung advantage namin over the other chain, coffee chains, is we roast our coffee. So, fresh parating coffee natin. Aside from using quality beans, no? Here we have our espresso machine wherein we do our espresso for our base drink like cappuccino, americano, latte, flat white, gato, eucalypt. Okay, let's move to the other bar. Here we have our clover. It's a precision brewer wherein we brew our coffee. It's automatic. We set a program for temperature, for the extraction time. Okay. On the far end, we have our manual slow brew bar. For me, basically, yung water. So water plays an important role in having a good cup of coffee. And then coffee, kailangan fresh parati yung coffee mo. And then yung skill ng barista. And then lastly, yung machine. So plays an important factor also. It depends on the origin ng coffee. There are coffees na parang chocolate ang taste, nutty. And then some coffees are really good, like you can taste parang like wine. It's, it contains like, it tastes like fruits, like cherries, berries, and mga citrus note like lemon, orange. So ganun yung mga nice coffees. We source our coffee through a trader, no? Before we source it sa isang trader, we like to find out kung saan farm na kinuha. And then, gusto din namin graded yung coffee para maganda yung quality ng coffee. We normally get graded 2 coffees, meaning to say, less defects, kaya maganda yung quality niya. So yung mga source namin is like, this is from Brazil, Colombia, Costa Rica, Hawaii, Sumatra. And paminsan nag-try kami ng ibang coffees from different countries. We source from Benguet and Bukidnon. He's like yung medyo nakatutok sa farming projects namin wherein he asks people from abroad to help mga local farmers. So we directly help the farmers by teaching them how to plant, how to harvest, and how to take care of their beans, basically.
Coffee is always getting good, and the guys at Craft Coffee Workshop are doing their part to help get it better. Taking care of coffee and the people who make it is all part of their business.
Yung practice namin dito, like yung mga barista namin, like si Kevin, si Miko, and Aldrin, they were all trained. So kaya definitely okay yung coffee na sinaserve namin sa dito. Ang mga barista namin, aside from their skill, they like to interact with our clients. So, yun, because of that, people come back for not just coffee, but to talk with our guys. And then siguro yung quality ng coffees namin, so people tend to buy coffees from us because of the quality of our coffee. We hope na we could educate people na there is more about coffee, not just yung mga nakasanayan natin coffee. Na there is much more na may merong good coffees, they can taste better coffee. Hopefully, they'll try our coffee.
Welcome back to Green Living. Today we're talking about recycling your plastic bottles. Now, how important is it to recycle plastic bottles? Well, first off, it helps in the conservation of oil. You heard right. When 1 ton of plastic bottles are recycled, approximately 3.8 barrels of oil used in production are saved. It can also reduce energy consumption. Producing plastics from recycled materials requires only 1/3 of the energy needed to manufacture raw materials. Reduced energy consumption means that recycled products will be cheaper to produce, so prices stay low on many products. Reducing energy consumption also limits the effects of air and water pollution, along with the emission of greenhouse gases. First up in our bottle DIY, a vase. We'll be needing a cylindrical plastic bottle, kitchen scissors, and decorative stones. First, mark and cut the smooth middle portion of the bottle. Next, measure and make straight, evenly spaced cuts all the way around the bottle. Then, carefully press and fold all the strips outward to make a level edge all the way around. Press the bottle upside down on a flat surface to ensure an even edge. Next, weave the tip of a strip over the next one and under the next two. Continue around in this pattern until the last three and tuck each one under the next until woven in completely. And there you go, your own plastic vase. When we come back, I'll show you another great way to recycle your plastic bottles. But first, here is Margot Lau to show us the different ways to make delicious recipes from raw food.
My name is Margot Lau. I am a raw foodie. I also teach Ashtanga yoga, yin yoga, and anti-gravity yoga. I'm a very active person. I'm actually a mother of two. And when I turned 39, I realized na I was very tired, although I was very healthy. I was a vegetarian, and then I practiced yoga every day. But I felt that I didn't have that much energy that I had when I was younger. So I really wanted to look for a healthy way of eating. I wanted to find something that I'm able to sustain all the activities I want in the day. So I really tried to look into raw foodism. And then when I started my last year, I really had so much energy. I felt really good. All my allergies, I have rhinitis, I have a lot of pimples, I have seborrheic dermatitis, typical problems when you get older. And all these disappeared after I started eating a lot more greens, I started eating a lot more fruits. My daily routine, I actually get up around 5:30. And then I prepare all my food now. I prepare my juices. I drink 1 liter of green juice a day. And then if I am going to be very active that day, I prepare another 1 liter of green smoothie. And then I have a lot of baon because I don't want to get hungry. When I start getting hungry, that's really the time that I start cheating. I start eating whatever because I'm so hungry. So ginagawa ko talaga, I really have a baon. I have fruit, I have green smoothies, I also have the green juices, and it really lasts me throughout the day. This is what I do in the morning. When I wake up in the morning, I prepare my juice. That's like baon ko nila sa umaga. And then right after I do yoga or I do running or I go gymnastics, this is what I drink. The first thing is I put some cucumber. Cucumber is actually equivalent to 3 glasses of water. So just 1 cucumber hydrates you. And then I put some ampalaya. It can clean out the blood and the toxins. So I really have put this one. I don't miss this. I put some sugar beets. I like my juice to be a little bit sweet. Sugar beets is really good for the liver. It's a liver detoxifier. And I put some, you know, some tomatoes. Because I don't know, when I was young, diba, they say na if you eat a lot of kamatis, you'll have really rosy cheeks. So I put some kamatis. And then I have some pechay here, pechay greens. And then I have some carrots for beta carotene. Actually, ever since I've been taking this green juice, I noticed that nawala yung astigmatism na mata ko. I noticed that I have better eyesight. Does that make sense? And then just to taste, no? I don't want to put a lot of sweet fruit, so I just put, just to make it a little sweet, so it's easier for me to take. I just put some green apples. I've been doing a lot of green smoothies. I just did a lot of free demos in most yoga studios around the country. I'll start with putting some carrots. Ang palaya. Just put everything in. First, they were really skeptical because they see a lot of greens, and then usually when you see the color green, you associate it with something that doesn't taste good or tastes like ampalaya or tastes like dahon. And they were very surprised when they make the green smoothies. They really like it because it really tastes like dessert.
Cucumber, of course.
And then tomatoes. A lot of people have been approaching me, especially for detox. Now they want to go on detox, they want to lose weight. And I always tell them that in my experience, I experienced so much fad diets in my life that I realized really that it's not important to starve yourself. You have to feed yourself nutrients, and these nutrients really come from fresh fruits and vegetables. And when you're able to reset your taste buds, reset your body, you don't have that much cravings for a lot of foods that you used to crave. So it's more of a transitional diet if you want to get into raw food from a cooked food diet. If you notice, you see all that bubble on top. Don't take the bubbles because it causes gas. We don't like gas. So actually, what's good about this jug is just you pour it out and then it just separates the bubbles from the juice. And then this is actually what I drink. It's really, really super hydrating. This is what you need every day. This is what your body needs. These are like good enzymes, nutrition that your body is really hungry for. Cheers! Yum! It's so good. If you're just starting out with this type of diet, the best is to just have like a green smoothie a day or a green juice a day. Just incorporate fresh fruits and vegetables into your diet. When you're eating white rice, you can substitute it by having more fruit. If you're still hungry, you can have a little brown rice. And then you can do away with white sugar and instead have a lower glycemic sugar like cocoa sugar. That would be good. I think that whatever we eat really defines who we are. If we're eating unhealthy, then it defines how we feel. If we feel bad about what we eat, we feel bad about who we are. And the more healthy we're eating, the more that we're really actually taking care of our body. And the more we take care of it, the more energy we feel, the happier we are. And the more fruits and vegetables that you eat, it's amazing. It's like this sudden burst of energy and you want to go out and you have to go out, exercise, walk, run under the sun. It really wants to make you just get up and go. It changes your whole outlook in life and it makes you happier. It alleviates depression. What I've been doing, being vegetarian, being more vegan, going through the source of all living foods, I feel that that goes hand in hand with what I'm practicing, which is yoga. You are more compassionate to all the living creatures, and I feel that it's made me happier. It's made me a better person, and there's a lot of good karma that I'm feeling that. You know, that I'm doing a lot of free juicing, free demos, and I don't really earn anything from all these, but I feel good. It fulfills me.
Aside from the previously mentioned benefits of recycling plastic bottles, another importance in reusing them is in reducing landfill space.
Not having millions of plastic bottles in landfill can save about 6.7 cubic meters in landfill space. This space can then be used for other functions.
And now on to our next DIY project. Do you have any almost empty plastic bottles around your home? Are you bothered whenever your cell phone charges and it hangs from the outlet? Well, you may want to try this next project. It's a holder for your charging cell phones.
You'll need a plastic bottle that's flat in shape rather than circular. Kitchen scissors, a marker, some sandpaper, and paper or paint. First, measure your phone against the bottle to make sure your bottle has the right fit. Next, mark the front and back of your bottle according to your phone's height. Then, cut your bottle and cut another curved box shape on the upper back half of the bottle. Now, using your sandpaper, smoothen the edges and sand the surface of the bottle. You can now use colored papers to design and decorate your bottle, using thinned down white glue as an adhesive.
Well, that's one problem solved. No more phones hanging from the outlets. There's a lot more different ways to recycle your plastic bottles, so you better think twice before throwing them away. Well, that's all I've got for you in this episode. For the instructions to these projects, you can visit our website, www.greenliving-tv.com, or follow us on Twitter and like our Facebook page. I'll see you guys next week right here on Green Living. What do you usually see aside from papers? Welcome back to Green Living. Today we're talking about recycling. Aside from the previously mentioned benefits. It's a holder for